So, this is the problem given. Also, there is some data given here. Crank rotates counterclockwise at 120 RPM. Crank length AB is equal to 150 millimeter. Then slotted arm OC is equal to 700 millimeter, and link CD is equal to 200 millimeter, is equal to 200 millimeter. So very first step here is draw the configuration diagram. So for that, what I'll do is initially let us take a line. Then measure 700 millimeter or 7 centimeters. That is, I'll take a scale here. For every 100 mm is equal to 1 centimeter. Therefore, what I'll do is I'll consider 7 centimeters. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So I'll consider 7 centimeter. From here, for 4 centimeters, I'll draw a line. This is link OA, which is fixed. Okay. So I don't have a compass. Anyways, I'll try with the scale itself. So we know the link OA is 45 degree to this straight line. 45 degree to this straight line. And it is equal to the length AB. Sorry, length AB is 1.5 centimeters. 1.5 centimeters. So this is length. This is B1. Now, link OC is 700 mm. So this is link C. So sorry, this is point C. From point C, D, that is link CD, is equal to 200 millimeter or 2 centimeters. So it should come on this line of stroke. So this is your point D or the slider. Point D or the slider. So this is 45 degree. So here again we have a slider. As I've explained already, this is the slider here. So we know certain things here. Using that we can find out, that is, speed with which the link is rotating, 120 RPM. So you can find out easily the angular velocity of link AB. So the angular velocity of link AB is 2 pi NAB divided by 60. So when I substitute in the formula, I'll obtain the value of 12.5663 radians per second. Okay, so this is the value of omega AB. When you know omega AB, it is easy to find out the linear velocity, that is VAB is equal to omega AB into the link length AB. So we know omega AB, link length of AB is 150 millimeter, that is 0.15 meters. So when you substitute those values in this equation, you will find the linear velocity of A with respect to, so that is B with respect to A, 1.88 meter per second. So now next step is drawing the velocity diagram. So we know the value here, 1.88 meter per second is the value for the linear velocity of AB. So now using this, I'll take the scale as 0.5 meter per second is equal to 1 centimeter. 0.5 meter per second is equal to 1 centimeter. So therefore, what will happen to VAB? VAB is equal to 1.88 divided by 5, so that will be equal to 3.76 centimeters. Now what I'll do is I'll consider a point O comma A, because O and A are fixed here. Now consider link AB first. So the velocity, that is the linear velocity, will act exactly perpendicular to this link, right? So, and we have the value for that also. This is your VAB. So we have the value for that also. We have found out the value, 3.76 centimeters. So for exactly parallel to this line, I'm going to draw a line of 3.76 centimeters. 3.76 centimeters. So this is velocity AB. So this is the velocity AB. Now let us consider the slider BB1. This link has got a common point, that is B1. By considering this, when the slider moves, okay, it will move in this direction as well as in this direction. So the velocity will be seen along the line of stroke, So, but magnitude is unknown. So exactly parallel to this line, I'll draw a line of unknown magnitudes. So this is, see here, this is velocity of B with respect to B1 downwards, and this is velocity of B1 with respect to B, Now let us consider the link OB1, so this is point B here. So let us consider the link OB1. Again, the velocity, the linear velocity, will be acting exactly perpendicular to this link, like this, right? So this is your VOB1. So what I'll do is I'll draw a line exactly parallel to this using O. So this is point B1 and this is velocity OB1, velocity vector OB1. Now on this line we have to spot C also, we have to mark C also. For that, what I'll do is I'll again consider the similarity principle, that is small OC divided by small OB1 is equal to capital OC divided by capital OB1. So here when I measure small OB1, the value is 2.8. So OC we have to find out, this is 2.8. OC we have already found out, that is OC has been given, so that is 700 millimeter. So now when I consider OB1 and when I measure it using the configuration diagram, so it will be 5.2, that is 520 millimeter. So now it is easy to find out OC here. So let me calculate it. So 700 divided by 520 into 2.8. So the value of OC is 3.769 centimeters. So here on this line we have already measured 2.8. So go till 3.8, almost equal to 3.8. So this is point C. This is the point C. Now let us consider the link CD here. So how will be the velocity acting here? So velocity will be exactly perpendicular to this link. So this is your VCD. Similarly, using C, I'll draw VCD. VCD, we do not know the magnitude. So what I'll do is I'll draw a line of unknown magnitude. So now let us consider D, that is the slider D. Either it will move in this direction or it will move in this direction, that is this is VD or this is VD. If I draw in this direction, it has got no sense. Therefore what I will do is exactly parallel to that, or for 0 degrees, I am going to draw a line using O, and this is the meeting point and this is the intersection point, which is known as D. So this is VCD and this is VD. Now in the question he has asked us to find out VD. So what I'll do is I'll measure VD first. Using scale, measure VD, it is 3.7 centimeters. Multiply it with the scale. Do not forget this. If you forget, so obviously whatever you do will be wrong. So it is 3.7 into 0.5. 1.85 meter per second is the value for VD. Now let us find out VDC also, VDC or VCD. So I'll consider the scale, I'll take the scale, I'll measure this distance. It is 0.9. So 0.9 into 0.5, that is the scale, will give us 0.45 meter per second value. Now let us consider VOB1. So measure this distance here. It is already been calculated. OB1 is 2.8. So 2.8 into 2.8 into 0.5, that is 1.4 meter per second. Also we can calculate VOC also. VOC, so OC is also calculated, 3.769. see here, it is also calculated, 3.8 into 0.5 1.9 meter per second. So even we can calculate VBB1 also. So this is the distance VBB1, that is velocity of a point with of a slider with respect to a point. So we are considering a point here B1, our slider is sliding B up and down. So velocity of a slider with respect to point VBB1 is 2.6 into 0.5, so that is 2.6 into 1.3 meter per second. Now the next step is drawing the acceleration diagram. So in order to draw the acceleration diagram, what I am going to do is I am going to construct a table. As we all know already, links, their lengths in meter, their velocity is in meter per second, then the centripetal acceleration, which is given by v square by r in meter per second square, then the tangential acceleration. Here tangential acceleration for the first link, okay we'll discuss that. So we have links here, AB, OB1, OC, CD, and finally the then the finally the slider. Slider has no lengths. So okay, now let us consider the length of AB, that is 0.15 meters already given. So when I calculate this, 1.8, and the velocity found out of VAB, VAB is 1.88, velocity is 1.88 meter per second. So when I calculate this using the calculator, that is 1.88 square divided by 0.15, that is equal to 23.56. Now for this link, no angular acceleration is given, okay, that is alpha is not given, therefore centripetal acceleration itself becomes the original acceleration. So let us move on to the next link, OB1. See, OB1 has been found out using the configuration diagram. So this is 0.52 meters. So 0.52, and the velocity of OB1 is also calculated, that is 1.4 meter per second. So that is 1.4 square divided by 0.52, that is 3.769 meter per second square. We do not know the magnitude of AT, and AT is found out by using the formula alpha into R. Now let us consider the next link OC. Directly in the problem itself, OC link length is given as 700 millimeter, that is 0.7, and the velocity of OC is found out to be 1.9 meter per second. 1.9 meter per second. So what I'll do is 1.9 square divided by 5.175. So next link is CD. CD is also given directly in the question itself. It is 200 millimeter or 0.2 meters. So now velocity of CD is also calculated. See, here is the velocity of CD, 0.45 meter per second. So when I calculate that, 0.45 square divided by 0.2, so it is 1.0125 meter per second square. Now velocity of D is also known to us, 1.85 meter per second. Now using this data, I'm going to draw the acceleration diagram. But here very important thing is, until now we have not found out the Coriolis component of acceleration of slider B with respect to a point, coincident point B1. So here, as I've already told you, slider is B, there is a coincident point B1. Okay, so I will find out component of slider B with respect to coincidental point B1. So that is, see, this is how it is represented. So now it is equal to 2 omega v. Yesterday the video which I have posted, okay, consists the derivation of this formula and what exactly is Coriolis component, why we should consider the Coriolis component, and what are the directions. Everything has been explained in that video. So now, so this is equal to 2. So the slider is on the link OC. So angular velocity of OC and velocity of the slider with respect to that point VBB1. So now omega OC can be found out by the formula VOC divided by 2 into VOC divided by link length OC into VBB1. So substitute the values here. VOC we have found out 1.9 divided by OC. OC is known to us, that is 700.7, into VBB1 is 1.3 meter per second. So using this, I'll just find out the value for the Coriolis component of acceleration of slider B with respect to coincidental point B1. So 1.9 divided by 0.7 into 1.3 into 2. So the Coriolis component is 7.1. 7.0571, okay, we can consider that as 7.1 meter per second square. Now we have to take the scale. Let us take the scale as 2 meter per second square is equal to 1 centimeter. 2 meter per second square is equal to 1 centimeter. So what will happen here? So AC of AB will be equal to, after the conversion to the scale, 23.56 divided by 2, that is 11.78 centimeters. Next, when I consider OB1, that will be equal to 3.769 divided by 2, 1.8845, we can take that as 1.9 centimeters. Then AC of OC 5.175 divided by 2, that is equal to 2.6 we can consider. Now the last link CD, 1.1 divided by 2, that is 0.55 centimeter, and we have got the Coriolis component also for BB1, so that is 7.1 divided by 2, that is 3.55 centimeter. So using this these values, I'm going to construct the acceleration diagram. So for that, again we have to consider point O comma A. So very first thing is consider link AB. So always, as I have told you, the centripetal acceleration acts towards the center of rotation, acts towards the point of rotation of center of rotation. So this is the centripetal acceleration of AB. So exactly parallel to this link, I am going to draw a line which is equal to 11.78 centimeters. One second, let us get some more space here. So I'll consider point O comma A from here. So here, from here, I'll measure 11.78 or 11.8. 11.8. So I'll draw a line. This is the centripetal acceleration of AB, which is also equal to the original acceleration of AB. Now let us consider the slider B. So as we have found out the value of the Coriolis component of slider B with respect to a coincidental point B1, that is 3.55 centimeters, but what is the direction? We do not know what is the direction. So yesterday in the video I have clearly explained the directions also. So when I consider a link which is rotating in a clockwise direction about a fixed point, if the slider is moving downwards with the velocity BB1, as in this case, so always the Coriolis component will be acting perpendicular to the velocity and in this direction. So now let us consider this slider, and exactly perpendicular to this I'm going to draw a line of 3.55 centimeters. That is 3.5. But the direction will be in this direction. So this is Coriolis component of B1. So now this is point B. Now this slider itself will have this radial component also, or the centripetal component also, which will be in this direction or maybe in this direction. So again, what I have to do is I have to draw a parallel line exactly to this line, and the magnitude of this line is unknown. The magnitude of this line is unknown. Magnitude of this line is unknown. Okay, now let us consider the link OB1. Let us consider the link OB1. Let us consider the link OB1. So here there are two components acting. One is again the radial component or centripetal component towards the center of rotation, and again another component which is exactly perpendicular to this link. So this is what I have told you, VOB1, either in this direction or this direction, we do not know. So what I am going to do is, initially I am going to draw again a parallel line from point O, and we know the value OB1 is 1.9 centimeters. OB1 is 1.9 centimeters. So 1.9 centimeters I'm going to draw. So this is the tangential or centripetal or radial component of BB1. In this direction. So this is again the centripetal component of OB1. So exactly perpendicular to this line. If I draw a line this is the tangential component of OB1. It intersects this line, that is the centripetal component of BB1 here. This is termed as B1. So join AB1, OB1. Join OB1. So this is the resultant. See here. See, this is centripetal acceleration. This is the tangential acceleration. This is the resultant. Both are moving in the same direction. So obviously, this will be in the opposite direction. AB1. Now we have to find out point C. We have only OB1, but we have to find out point C. So again, take the similarity principle, that is small OC by small OB1 is equal to capital OC divided by capital OB1. So here OC has to be found out. OB1, let us measure it. It is 3.3 centimeters. So 3.3. OC we know, that is 700. Directly in the problem itself he has given. OB1 we have calculated using the configuration diagram, that is 520. So therefore OC will be equal to 700 divided by 520 into 4.442, that is 4.4. okay, so we know this value, this is 3.4. I'll extend the line till 4.4. So this is point C. Now let us consider link CD. So link CD is having a centripetal component, as it can be shown here. Centripetal component of acceleration. Okay, so exactly to this line or this link, I am going to draw a parallel line using C, and we know the value also, it is 0.55, which is 0.55. So this is the centripetal acceleration of link CD or CD. Now exactly parallel to this, that is, when I consider the link CD, see, this is how the velocity, the acceleration will be perpendicular to the link. So either it may be in the upward direction or in the downward direction, we do not know. So now if I draw downwards, so it is of no use at all, no sense. So the magnitude of AT of CD is not known, so I'll draw a line of unknown magnitude, Now consider the last thing, that is the slider. Slider will move in this direction or in this direction. So this is the acceleration of D in this direction. So again, what I'll do is exactly parallel to that, or exactly at 0 degrees, I'll draw a line from O. So it intersects this point here. So this is your ATCD. Now it is intersecting this line ATCD at this point here. So this is D. This is D. Now what I'll do is, this is your AD. Now connect these two points C and D, because see here, this is the centripetal acceleration and this is the tangential acceleration. When you connect these two points, this is your, see, it is moving in this direction, it is moving this direction, so obviously it should be opposite. So this is your AC of CD, total acceleration of CD. So this completes the acceleration diagram. But one more thing we have left out, and a very important thing, that he has asked us to find out AD, that is acceleration of slider D. So let us measure this AD, that is OD. It comes to be 3.1 centimeters. So that is multiplied by the scale. Scale is 2. So obviously it is 6.2 meter per second square. Now again, one more thing is left out in the question. He has asked us to find out the acceleration of the slotted lever. Slotted lever is B1O or OB1. So it can be given by the formula: tangential acceleration of the slotted arm divided by the link length OB1. So let us measure AT of OB1. Where is AT of OB1? So this is the AT of OB1. We'll measure it using the scale here. It is 2.8 centimeters. 2.8 divided by the link length, 2.8 into scale we have to do, that is 2, divided by the link length OB1, which is measured using the configuration diagram, as 0.52. So this will be equal to 2.8 into 2 divided by 0.52, 10.77 meter per second square. So this completes the whole problem. So initially you have to draw the configuration diagram, then the velocity diagram as I have done. Find out the velocities. Those velocities are used in the acceleration diagrams to find out the centripetal acceleration. And here, as the slider is moving up and down as well as rotating with the link, so we have to find out the Coriolis component for the slider B with respect to a coincidental point B1. So take the scale, divide all the values with the scale, list it out like this. Now draw the acceleration diagram, and this completes the problem. So kindly subscribe to my channel. Further, all the syllabus will be done like this and uploaded in the